The main subject, as I told, is number one, man, guidance for man. First of all, at the individual level, his thinking should be correct. His personality should be a normal, moral personality. His character should be strong. He should take to the right path, individually as well as socially. The social system should be based on justice. There should be no exploitation. There should be no repression. So the guidance at the philosophical level and guidance at the social level. Please note these two words. Because every human being needs a philosophy of his own. He must have some view, world view. He must have some Weltanschauung. He must have some philosophy. What he thinks about this universe. What is this universe? What he thinks about himself. Who am I? Where from I have come? Where I am heading? Where I am going? Is death the end of my existence? Or there is some form of life beyond death also? What is evil? What is good? Are there any permanent values, ethical values of good and evil? Or, as you say, nothing is good or bad, only thinking makes it so. What's true? Then what is knowledge? How to acquire it? We know that we can understand and we can learn knowledge through our sense organs. We know that we can argue and infer by this computer. But is that all human knowledge? Or is there any other source of knowledge also? What is man? Is he only a human, an animal? A slightly more evolved animal than the lower animals? Or he is basically different from animals? Everybody must have some view of all these questions, some answers. And even if he doesn't have them consciously, if you analyze his behavior, you will find that he is holding this or that view. Either he believes in the life hereafter or he doesn't believe. He might be professing that he believes, but his attitude in life is telling that he doesn't believe in any life after death. He doesn't believe in any resurrection. So everybody has a philosophy, either consciously or unconsciously. Most of the people, they accept the philosophy or Weltanschauung or worldview of the society in which they are born. 99.9 recurrent percent people, they accept that those norms. People, whatever they are believing, they start believing, and then they start their life, actual life, practical life. They don't think about anything more. But you know, but as I told you, if you analyze, they have some view. So actually, first of all, these subjects which you call metaphysics, which you call ethics, which you call psychology, which you call epistemology, metaphysics, it deals with the nature of existence. What is existence? What is the physical world? Is it all? Or there is something beyond this physical world? Then what is ethics? Morals. Moral values. Are they permanent or changing? Then even if we accept that moral values are permanent, to tell a truth is good. What will compel me to tell a truth, even when I find that it is going to be harmful for me? I can be saved if I tell a lie. Still, I must tell the truth. Why? So there should be some motivation. What is the motivating force to make a man an ethical person, a moral person? And then, you know, as I told you, epistemology. What is knowledge? Psychology. What's human mind? How it works? What are the passions? What are the emotions? What are the animal instincts? What is the id or libido? What is ego or superego? Now, all these questions are very central to the subject of Quran. Because these subjects actually are dealt with in what we call Iman. Iman is a worldview. Iman is a philosophy. Iman actually is a Weltanschauung. It's a philosophy, a total philosophy about metaphysics, about psychology, about ethics, and about the epistemology.